for taking part for the involvement in the JVP. But I was not a JVP militant. I had a heated argument with the Rohan Vijayveera against his Indian expansionism. I was against him. So I was hunted by him. He tried to kill me several times. My house was completely demolished by JVP, and I was shot 3 times on stages, but I was fortunate enough to save my life. And even in the jail, I was, there were about 2 or 3 people against JVP, all others were JVP. So even inside the prison, I was harassed, embarrassed, and a lot of difficulties I had to face inside the prison. I have worked in People's Bank as a clerk. In the same time, I attended the classes in the evening. In the evening, I was able to form a student organization, and my team was able to get the victory of that election. And I did sports also. I was Mr. University on those days in the contest of 5 universities. So God has given me so much of various opportunities. And my father was a Christian. My mother was a Buddhist. My father was from low country. My mother was from up country. My father is George Wilson Cooray. My mother is Herat Mudiyan Silagi Palingu Bednika. And they belong to 2 castes. So from my birth, I am mingled with everyone, everything. I am a mixed one. I am not a pure singleist. I am not a pure Buddhist. I am not a pure Christian. Nothing pure in my body, in my mind, nothing. All are mixed. All are mixed. That is the nature of our country also. Our country is located in a very important place in the Indian Ocean. So, because of this location, so many foreigners came to Sri Lanka. Chinese, Persian, Muslims, Portuguese, Dutch people, and British. So, I am sure all their blood is mixed in our nation. I am sure. Definitely. All the Muslims came to Sri Lanka without wives. They got Tamil wives and Muslim single wives. After that, they have changed their names, Fatima, Siddhya, but they are singleist and Tamil girls. All the blood is mixed. Our single kings married always Tamil ladies. So Tamil and singleist people are relations, whatever the political leaders say. That is the truth. That is the truth. We came from India. Single people came from India. Tamil people came from India. We got all our arts, all other science from India, culture from India. So we are a part of India, inseparable part of India. Sri Lanka is an inseparable part of India. Earlier, geographically, if you go through, those 2 countries were together. So Adam's Bridge is an evidence for that connection. So we have been together. But I want to say, the leader, who is the leader? If there is one person in the world, he will be a leader automatically. When there are a lot of people, there is a competition for the leadership. For every leader, there should be a group or a group of people, whatever it may be. That may be caste, that may be religion, that may be community, that may be whatever it may be the reason, for leaders there should be a team. If there is no such things, they will create some differences. The leaders are the people who create differences among the people. Now you take Lord Jesus Christ, Lord Buddha, all other religious leaders preached about the unity of the people, peace and harmony of the people. Now you, what is the reality? Oh, now all the religious leaders are creating disturbances all over the world. If you go through, what is behind? In almost all the war, when you go through the reasons, behind is a religion. That is why Rabindranath Tagore said in India, all the religious leaders preached unity, peaceful coexistence and harmony. But what the leaders are doing here? Lord Buddha did not care the caste system. He was born in India. Caste system was very powerful. But he was a fighter. 2500 years ago, he was fighting against the caste system. Not now. There are so many people, Marxists are there, revolutionaries are there, to fight against the caste. But Lord Buddha is the person who fought against the caste system in early days. Right. But what is now Buddhist leaders are doing? What are they doing? Now you know, in the down south, when you go, you will see there are three Nikayas. Siam, Rama, Nyamarapura Nikaya. What is behind that? Caste. Nothing else. Lord Buddha, does he have a caste? No, he was against the caste. But the leaders who follow the Buddhism create castes. Now our leaders are taking a lot of people from Germany, Canada, Thailand, and ordained as Buddhist monks. But our Buddhist monks were unable to ordain a Tamil into Buddhism. No Tamil Buddhist monk, no Tamil temple. Why is it? It is against the religion. So we have to understand all these things are creations of the leaders. Now in the history, Shanmugadasan, I am one of his followers. He was the leader of almost all the militant groups in the down south. Not a single is man. Rohana Vijayavira, G.I.D. Dharmasekhar, Kalyananda Tiranagam, Nihal Das, Anand Gulatil, Gamyapa, all the militant leaders. Who is the teacher? Shanmugadasan is the leader. Shanmugadasan is the leader of all the militant groups. What did he say? He has written a book about history. What we read about the histories is complete, utter fabricated lies. Distorted things. When they are writing Mahavamsa, they write as they want. Some other rewrites in another way. That is not the truth. Truth is somewhere else. History always talk about the prominent people, not about the common people. Nothing is written about the common people. Now, almost all the histories are written about the wars between kings. Great Alexander, Julius Caesar, and Mark Antony, and Ashok. What are these things? Fights between personalities. It is not a war between the common people. Rama, you know, Elar and Gamun. What is the war? Is it a war between Sinhalese and Tamils? No. It is not a war between... Mahavamsa writer said, Elar is a righteous king. One of the righteous king. A Buddhist bhikkhu has written his book and he said, Elara is one of the most righteous king in Sri Lanka. That is what he said. Then Duryodhana wanted to capture power. He used religion as a weapon, as a slogan. That's what he said. No, that is not a war between Tamils and Sinhalese. Most of the Sinhalese were fighting for Yara. That's the truth. When you take the army of Elara, most of the Sinhalese people were there. So that is not a war between Sinhalese and Tamils. Take Ram and Ravana. Now you are showing that fighting in a very heroic manner. What is it? Is it a war between Sinhalese and Tamils, Indians and Sri Lankans? No. It is a problem of a lady. Of a lady. Right? Then it is a fight between good and bad. That is not a fight between Tamils and Sinhalese. But what the leaders do, they tell all these things, teach all these things to the people to provoke more and more antagonism. That is what they do. That is what they do. So, in the same way, what I want to tell you is this. Sri Lanka is a beautiful country, fortunate country. You will realize it when you go abroad. Otherwise, you don't understand. When you go outside of the country, then only realize how beautiful, how fortunate country is Sri Lanka. Otherwise, you don't know. Unfortunately, Sri Lanka is an island. It is surrounded by Indian Ocean. We do not know what is happening outside of the island mentality. Jaffna is a peninsula. It is more conservative, more close society. A frog in the well thinks the sky is the size of the well. Then frog, sometime in the well there may be a bucket. In the well, the frog in the bucket will think the sky is size of the bucket. That is what happens here. Now we don't understand what is the real enemy. We have not understood where is the wrong. One thing is, history itself has become a barrier for us. History. History. Distorted things we believe and continue for future generations also. Right. Then we are provoking hate, enmity, jealous because of the incidents of the history. We have to forget, forgive and start a new life. And in the same time, we are always against for a change. Not only here, even the down south. When UNP government started Kandalama Hotel, we were against. We did demonstrations. But what is the situation now? It has been rewarded several times for the best hotel in Asia. We were against to parliament. Now we all are going there and enjoying doing our debates in the parliament. When the free trade zones are introduced, we were against. We said, our youngsters will be sent to work as slaves in the free trade zones. And I myself argued. One day when I was traveling by a train, there was a heated argument with the passenger. He said the UNP government is trying to make all our youngsters as slaves of their factories in Sri Lanka. Then one man asked a question from me. Have you ever seen a man who is eating a tube lights? I have seen. They are breaking the tube lights, eat and make money. I said, yes. Then what are you talking? In this country, the people are eating tube lights to earn something. You are talking nonsense about the factories in the free trade zone. Now what happened later? Now China also has started free trade zone. It's a socialist country. Right? We were against to the garment factories. Now it has become one of the major income generator. We were against to tourism in the down south. Almost all the Buddhist clergies, Christian fathers, and we were against to tourism. We said as a result of that our culture will be disappeared. Now what? What is the situation? Big income for the country. Right? So we are not ready for a change. So as a result of that, we are always backward. That backwardness is in the Jaffna, Northern province also. We had the same thing was in the down south, but we had overcome now. We are ready now. We are ready accepting. And we are developing our country. So they are earning money. But here, still when you are going to start the industry, a lot of objections are there. When a Tamil gentleman come to Jaffna and start manufacturing salt, then there is a protest. Somebody says it will hurt their fishing industry. In other side, some people going against, it will damage the paddy cultivation. That nonsense. No scientific base for that. So now no industry, no factory, no employment. Almost all the educated people went abroad. Now you don't have a cream light in Jaffna. You can see the real Tamil gentlemen in Canada, America, Argentina, those not here. The people who can't do anything, very innocent, incapable, poor people are only here, nobody else. Being there, they have gone out. Now you saw almost all the educated people are here, all the doctors. But 20 hospitals are without a doctor. When you go to down south, Dr. Murugesu, Dr. Nyanasekaram, Dr. Jayasekaram, in the cultural hospital, filled. They are ready to go to Munaragala Bibil also, not to Pungudutiv, Nainativ, Analativ. They are the people who talk about the liberation of the Tamil people. They are the people who talk about the liberation of the Tamil. Same thing in the outside also. This is the last stage. The next generation will not look at us. Diaspora, next generation will not. This is the last stage. If we don't take their help, if we send them back, we will lose forever. We will lose them forever. So we have to get the maximum advantage of that. I tried at my level best. As soon as I came, I tried to start the investment forum. I want to tell you this thing. I will not be able to tell all these things in future. So this is the opportunity to tell all you. The investment forum. What for? For me? No. For the benefit of the people in this area. Then what happened? I will tell you very bravely, the provincial council did not support me. Not all, but I don't like to mention the names. They wanted to change it and take the office back. And almost all the people have gone there. Nothing happened. You, Honorable Chairman has spoken about the Chief Minister's Fund. I have given him a good advice. Why don't you worry about the Chief Minister's Fund? You can get diaspora people's money in some other way. started trust. And if they open their mouth and tell to the diaspora people, send me $1 for the trust, for the development of the Jaffna, it will be a paradise. But so far they have not done it. Why? Why they have not done it? If it is a trust, it is a legal body. Accounting system is there. Accountability is there. No, nothing has happened. I have brought 20 acts, as Honorable Mayor said, and handed over to him. And said, you have very simple, you have to do, change the names and put it and pass it. And you know, after hard struggle, and the statute was passed for the transportation. I don't know whether the bylaws has been gazetted or not. It has to be gazetted. Otherwise you can't perform. But pass, not bylaws, has been gazetted. When I go through the Pradeshi Sabhas, do you know the amount of money has been accumulated in the accounts? 2,350 million in the accounts of the Pradeshi Sabhas. They keep as fixed use without doing work into the field. I will give you all the details, not only in one. I will give you. I have all the numbers. The big amount. They said no money. They said no money. Why? They are not sleeping. No roads, no toilets, nothing, but they keep money in the banks. Why is it? I can't understand. So there should be a leadership to drive them. No leadership, that is the problem. The other one, may I tell you, now once again, so many things. So I went with Mr. Ilangovan to meet diaspora friends. I went to UK, France, Germany,
Swiss.
Right. They have a protest against me. Go back to your country. Go back. Why did I come? I wanted to motivate them, invite them to invest here. They were ready because of the unfortunate political situation. Now they are again reluctant and hesitation. There should be a motivation. There should be an invitation. We should encourage them to do something here. What they say, for their fixed deposits in the Europe, they don't give 1% interest. But here, if they put money, they will get a 17%. No invitation. Nobody tells them. Earn there, spend here. A tourist from 1 month salary spends 6 months here without any difficulty. So earn money from European countries and spend here and invest here. This will be a paradise. Take the example of Israel. They didn't have a country. They were almost everywhere. If you start a campaign to invite your patriotism, one gentleman running Leica, the biggest company, Libera, another biggest company, one Mr. Rajasilan is the owner of the hotel in Doha where Winston Churchill was. And one Karan, owner of the container company. They are willing, they are ready. But no invitation, no motivation, no encouragement. We can make this area a paradise. So I am telling you, in the next time, you have to coordinate all these things. do something for the people of this country. In my case, I have tried my best. Then I have started a campaign to clean the city. I myself went along the road and collect the garbage and did everything as a scavenger. Not only to single, not I did do that thing in Singhalese areas. Being a Singhalese, I came to Jaffna and cleaned the roads and collect all the garbages. Went all. And I have started the tree planting campaign. Our mayor, Arnold, helped me a lot. What is the credit he got? He was criticized. He was criticized. But he was brave enough to continue that work. I think definitely, though I am not here, that greenery will be there forever to serve the people. My intention was to make Jaffna green and clean. That's all my intention. Honorable Tawarasa came on that day, Mr. Shavanyanam came on that day, on all both, every occasions. So we can do marvelous things still. Now you know solar power. Now within 25 years, you won't be able to get hydropower. There won't be oil resources will be over. Everything will be over. Then Jaffna is the center of the power because of the solar power. We didn't take any steps to help them. When they call land, a lot of objections. Nothing. Right? So these are the things we have to do. So I am humbly appealing wherever I am, I will go down south, but my heart is here. I will help you at my level best wherever I am. Because I think that is the only way for the unification of this country. Unification, development. We have to unite the country through development, through irrigation, through transportation, through technology, through education, through recreation, through sports. All these things are to be used to reunite this country. And what I am suggesting, I have advised my daughter to marry a Tamil man. I have advised her. Why? You know, when you go to one of my friends, he's in France. Now he has come back to Monaragal and cultivating. When the people become old, they don't like that country. They want to come back again. They said there is no life, no friends, no culture, no relationship, nothing, machines are there. So they want to come to Jaffna after a lot of abandoned houses. In Jaffna 1C, lot of abandoned houses. That are, those are the places breed mosquitoes, dengue, and unwanted things. So we have to take steps on that matter and pass laws and regulations for all these things. So I think now you have a right to fight for your political demands. It's okay. You're right. But in the same time, continue your work to serve the people. When I was a young man, I was a militant. I want to do a proletariat revolution through armed struggle. Then when a beggar comes to me, I don't give 10 cents. I said, I will not give you. Why? If I give you 10 cents, you will be encouraged to beg more and more. Then you are serving, helping to keep this system forever. So join with us, fight with us, win the struggle. 40 years has gone. What happened? No victory. Revolution has not been done. I didn't give a single cent to the beggars. Same thing here. I think, I firmly believe the India will never help. India will never help for a partition, for a struggle. They have their own agendas. They will go to that. If it is anything advantage, then only they will do that. Otherwise, no. You know the result. During the last victory, did they help? They didn't help. They didn't help. Because Mahinda Rajapaksa alone, he didn't win the war with the help of India. With the help of India, that is the actual truth. Why don't you say so? With the help of India, the Mahinda Rajapaksa was able to win the war. That is the naked truth, bitter truth. That's the truth. Likewise, we have to solve our problem within ourselves. Within ourselves. Continue your fight for your political ends. But you can conserve the people. Otherwise, they will. 13 years they have suffered. Innocent people. More than enough. That's suffering. So you will have to continue your struggle by helping the people. That is. Thank you very much. இன்று என்னுடைய வாழ்க்கை ஒரு முக்கியமான தினம். இன்று என்னுடைய வாழ்வில் ஒரு முக்கியமான தினம். மத்திய மலை மாகாணத்தில் நான் பிறந்தது. தெற்கு மாகாணத்தில் படித்தது. தெற்கு மாகாணத்தில் அரசியலாக சேவை செய்தது. வடக்கு மாகாணத்தில் 3 வருடம் ஆளுநராக இருந்தது. அதிமேக கௌரவ ஜனாதிபதி மைத்ரிபால சிறிசேன அவர்கள் நமக்கு நியமனம் கொடுத்தது, அவள் எடுத்தது. இந்த இடத்திலே நாம் வேறு இடத்துக்கு போக வேண்டும். கண்ணதாசன் ஐயா சொன்ன மாதிரி, எங்கே வாழ்க்கையை தொடங்கும் அது எங்கே இது முடியும். இதுதான் பாதி, இதுதான் பயணம் என்பது யாருக்கும் தெரியாது. பாதையெல்லாம் மாறி வரும், பயணம் முடிந்துவிடும். மாறுதலை புரிந்து கொண்டு மனிதன் தெரிந்து நினைப்பதெல்லாம் நடந்துவிட்டால் தெய்வம் வேண்டியதில்லை. நடந்ததை நினைத்திருந்தால் அமைதி என்றும் இல்லை. 30 வருடம் நடந்து என்னதை சொல்லி நினந்தி கதகிட்டி குரோதம் விரோதம் எடுத்தா ஒன்னும் கிடையாது. ஆனால் நாங்கள் எல்லோரும் சேர்ந்து forget and forget. You are calling to forget the militants in the prison. Right. That's also right. In the meantime, you are telling to put army people in the prison and punish them. So apply same policy for both. Apply same policy for both. The people who were dead, not the fighters, even the innocent people. Central Bank, Slave Island, Kathankudi Church, Sirma. Innocent people were killed, not the militants. That is not the war. So my suggestion is to forget and forgive. And start a new page in this country. Then I will come again and again. Now you are my relations, you are my friends. But nobody has invited me to come to your home and have a dinner. That may be your culture. But in our down south, we always invite friends to home, come eat, drink. But for the 3 years period, nobody invited. I'd like to come to your house and be with you and be friends and relationship to I in future also. We will get together. I will not stop my politics, I'll start it again. Now, being a governor, I couldn't do that. Now I will do that again in the down south. If I get the opportunity, I will do maximum to the Tamil people in this area. Because I know the Tamil people in the tea estate, the way they suffer for the benefit of the country. I know them. So I want to pay back them. Thank you very much.